Guys, we've been looking at homeostasis, and today let's go on with the components of a homeostatic system. Actually, what makes up a good homeostatic system? And number one, we have the reference point, the norm, or the set point. So when you talk about the reference point, it's simply the level of body entity at which the body system must operate, otherwise that required amount of something in a body at which that a certain process can occur. For example, we have the body temperature at 37. The body temperature at 37 degrees Celsius. So for efficient functioning of certain body processes, mostly those that are controlled by enzymes, the temperature should be at 37. The normal blood pH should be at 7.4, otherwise fairly alkaline for normal functioning of the enzyme. The blood glucose or the blood sugar level should be at 90 milligrams per 100 cubic centimeters of blood. As we are going to see, the importance of maintaining this concentration here in one of our next videos. So we have other set points, but that's only what we have afforded to look at. But what you have to know is that any deviation, any change from the above set points triggers homeostatic mechanism. Otherwise, any change from these set levels trigger, put in motion homeostatic mechanism, which are aimed at restoring the levels of these parameters. Yeah. Another component of the homeostatic system is the detector or receptor. So when we talk about detector and receptors, they are simply structures in our bodies that do detect and point out any change from the normal. Otherwise, we have seen the reference points, the normal points of different things. For example, I've said the temperature is 37. In case it goes below or above, it is these receptors or detectors that point out, that inform that there has been a change. And the example of the detectors, we have the thermoregulatory center in the hypothalamus. This part is a part of the brain, and in the hypothalamus, there is the thermoregulatory center, which detects any change in body temperature. As the temperature of the body increased or reduced, it is the work of this receptor known as the thermoregulatory center. We have the stretch receptors. These stretch receptors are found in the carotid and aortic bodies in blood vessels. And these ones are responsible for detecting changes in blood pressure. As blood pressure increased, as it decreased, we are still looking at the components of the homeostatic system. And let's go on and look at the control or regulatory center. We have heard of control and regulatory. So it's something that regulates that corrective mechanism. What you have to know is that the control or regulatory system, for it, it receives signals or impulses from various detectors. So detectors and receptors, after being informed that there has been a deviation from the set point, it sends the information to the regulatory center. But then this regulatory center also sends corrective measures or corrective instruction to the effectors in order to rectify or correct the deviation. And what you have to know is that the regulatory center or the control center in most cases is the nervous and the peripheral nervous system. Thank you. We talk about effectors. Effectors are simply muscles, glands, blood vessels, which set up now necessary changes which restore the reference point. Otherwise, they receive information from the control center and now respond. They bring about a response which restores the set point. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.